It is the middle of the evening, 5 central, what, you know, good evening, good night, good morning, depending on what time you're watching this or listening to this. Have a wonderful day. I got my hands full this week. I'm waiting on a potential guest to reach out to me. And until then, what we'll do is have traditional church. We'll do my show the way I usually do it. And I thank you for being a part of it. As you all know, I was taught that in the event that you have a program where as you're publicly speaking, you are to give homage to your ancestors. So each and every show, I take time out my evening to acknowledge my ancestors that have transitioned and the ones who are here I always support as well. Those are the people that are in the part of my family with the name Whitmore, Pollard, Turner, Battle, Cotton, Harper, Bailey, Crisp, Lansdowne, Ligons, Duncan, and you already know me and my father, my mother, my sisters, my brothers, we are part of the Williams Clan. And again, thank you for sharing your evening. Like I said, I got a special guest coming up. And I'm going to do that periodically. I'm going back to the original format, whereas I'm talking to people as well. You won't just hear me talking. I'm talking to people who have success stories. And those success stories will potentially lead us into hope and things of that nature. When you do things like that, what you do is let people see that, hey, even no matter where you come from or what background you have, there's no such thing as failing. Or, you know, we call failure that stumbling blocks that learn opportunities to learn from what you've done or even show you how far you've come from the beginning. So I try to bring somebody in with a success story. Some of these people are what we call celebrities. Others are just regular people who are doing wonderful things. Again, thank you for tuning in. This is just part of starting. Now, there's been a lot of turmoil in our community. There's been a lot of heresy. And sometimes we hold on to it too much. And what I mean by holding on to too much is this. We're using too much social media, people. I personally have suffered from, I wouldn't call it an anxiety attack, but I would call it a bowel anxiety a couple of nights ago. I was looking at, you peek in on Facebook, and I kept seeing death, 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 death. People reminding you of people in their families dying. People reminding you of how bad this COVID-19 thing is. And it got, I went to sleep. And I don't know, I turned over too fast or was breathing too hard. I don't know what the hell was going on. I took a deep breath. And subconsciously, it didn't feel right. And it took me, I'm a person who's, I go to sleep like a knocker. I never have issues sleeping, but I felt uneasy. My breathing was funny. And now all of a sudden, I'm starting to question if I have issues with this COVID-19. And after about 15 minutes, I realized that I'm digesting too much negativity. Last thing I saw was 2019 equals death. And I know that affected me subconsciously. And I consider myself a mentally strong individual. And I focus and I talk to myself. I slow down. I meditate and things of that nature. So a lot of things don't really get to me. And I just want to warn you guys against the same kind of things. With whatever you feed your brain, and that's what will process and come out and either hurt or harm you, or either slow you down momentarily. And it slowed me down momentarily because I wasn't able to get proper rest. When you're unable to get proper rest, is a chain reaction of things. And we don't even realize that these things are going on because it's called Facebook friends. And whether we want to admit it or not, a lot of our friends and family members bring chaotic situations into our lives. And so as I sit here today and talk to you guys, I want to continue to remind you, don't suck in all that negativity. Don't suck in all that foolishness that's on social media. Now, if you like social media, I'm not saying don't do it. I'm just saying just be aware of what you're putting inside your mental. because I'm telling you, it hit me. It didn't hit me hard, but if I hadn't even thought about it, you never know. I could have been in a full blown panic attack. I could have been rushed to the hospital. It could have been a million and one issues I could have had. And to avoid those things, just watch what you're processing. Watch what you upload into your head every night, every day, and you could potentially beat this thing. Because the last thing I want to do is go to a hospital, because I don't know if they're weaponizing this COVID-19 thing. I don't know what the hell is going on. But what I do know, it is just a lot of sick people at hospital. And I may go in because I'm having an anxiety attack, kind of contact with the wrong person, and now I'm COVID-19 positive. So do the best to maintain a specific state of health. Otherwise, this thing can sneak up and hurt you too. Another thing. This is the most important thing I'm going to say today. Self-check is extremely important. And what I mean by self-check is this. I do a lot of lipofuscin on my show. I think we need to do this. This is the direction I would like us to go into. I open the lines at times and ask for feedback. While doing that, in a lot of cases, we find ourselves going, yeah, that was a good, I get people going, hey man, that was a good show. I really enjoyed you. I needed to hear that, yada, yada, yada. Well, that's where the self-check comes in. This week, I had to check myself. If you listen to the show regularly, you've heard me say, look, we don't have a position in the world as our community, black community, to say, I'm not messing with somebody because I have a personal issue with you. You've heard me say that, because when our numbers are not great enough, our power is not strong enough to not deal with somebody. And I let my emotions get the best of me about 2 weeks ago, and I yelled and screamed at somebody. And from their perspective, they were right. From my perspective, I was right. But because I was in an emotional state, I stopped talking to this person. And at the end of the day, I don't know if this person ever did anything to me or not. I just was going on feelings, and I was emotional. And I was like, man, to hell with this guy. Which makes me the biggest hypocrite in the world. I'm bigger than most hypocrites. We all have hypocrisy in our lives. We all are double-minded at some point. We all say we're going to do one thing and do something totally different. But the reason I'm a bigger hypocrite, because most people don't get on air and say what we should do as a community and then go totally the opposite. So I'm a bigger hypocrite. I'm a bigger hypocrite. A bigger hypocrite than most. So what I did was I called this guy. And I said, yo, man, I don't want you saying anything. I'm just going to apologize to you. And what we're going to do is rebuild this relationship. And thank God this dude accepted my apology. And the reason I say thank God is this. The last time I popped off like that, I was 14 years old. Jumped in this guy's face, went off on it for no reason at all. That guy has never spoken to me again. He's talking about 1985, and now it's 2020. So you never know who can help you or who will be there for you when you let your emotions be the best of you and you react without thinking these are the things that happen. So be mindful of the things that you do and say, because at the end of the day, you will be tested. That's just the way the universe works. You put that energy out there, you want people to stand up and salute at what you're talking about. What will happen is, if everything that you say, the universe will test you in regards to that, and then we'll see if you get past it or fail and grade. That's just the way it works. I failed. Hopefully me telling you this, is giving you this information, will allow you to pass in the future. But at this point, I'm working towards being a better individual, and I hope you guys do the same. Now, as I speak about that, when I speak about the anxiety, and I speak about the things that we see on social media, and I think about the things that we see in the news and things like that, I am also forced to remind you guys that we are under attack as a community. And what I mean by we're under attack as a community is this. Our women are under attack. Our children are under attack. Our seniors are under attack. And you're under attack, brothers. Now, I understand that it's an attack on the poor community or the working class community, but I'm really not concerned with the entire world. I'm just concerned with the people that we have to interact with, because more than likely, your kids will interact with people look like my kids interact with people like your kids, grandkids, nieces, nephews, cousins, so forth and so on. So we have to, like I said a couple weeks ago, we have a broken leg in this community. We can't help anybody else walk until our leg is healed and we take care of things that we have to take care of. And I mean that. Now, with that being said, what we have to do is this. I'm looking at the situation and there are certain steps that we have to take. If you know anything about history, the last time something like this happened was pre the Great Depression. Contrary to popular belief, the Great Depression did not stop the crash of the stock market. The Great Depression started with in regards to banking and things of that nature, but they always tell you that to be the boogeyman to make you feel like the stock market is the most important thing in our economy, and that's just not, that is not true. That's just a lie. I'm going to tell you that's a lie. Don't let anybody tell you that. Do some history, do some reading, you'll see it. Everything that I ever tell you will be, you can look it up. And I'm going to start handing out books so people can look these things up and put yourself in a better situation so you won't panic when you see things like that. Because the entire get down is designed to keep you off balance. And if it can keep you off balance, it will keep you off balance. And that's just the honest God truth. You don't have to believe me. It's just, if you notice, everything that you see on TV is never solution-based. It's always problem-based. So if you always showing me a problem, then you're not in the business of fixing things. You're in the business of destroying my mental space. And if you destroy my mental space, you will destroy me. So, and if you destroy me, you destroy my family. And it's a chain reaction. It's a domino effect. And that's just the way the world works, people. And you know, if you don't understand that, I'm sorry, I can't help you. But if you do understand it, allow me to proceed. If you go back in history, when America struggles, we get the brunt of it. Notice this thing, what brought America out of the Great Depression was two things. World War II, and this thing presented by the president called the Big Deal. The Big Deal excluded you and I, because it excluded people who were farm workers and people who worked in service. Those were the jobs that we were primarily allowed to have. And if you know anything about the past, we were doing the farming, we were doing the cleaning and things of that nature. So if you exclude those two people, you exclude us. If we're primarily employed by those things, so forth and so on. So that lets you know right there, 100 years ago, me and you were under attack. Our ancestors were under attack. The reasons we were sitting here were under attack. And the same thing is happening right now. The exact same thing is happening right now. So, what came along with that was a heightened sense of entitlement by white America, white men primarily. And white men started to attack people in our community. When you listen to great director, great Bill Duke, Bill Duke tells the story of how when he was a child. So this is just lets you know that, you know, we always act as if slavery or the greatest argument against us, that was a long time ago. No, the hell it was. We're talking about Bill Duke walking around today. Look who's making television shows, movies, and things, and directing things today. He might have something, or before this COVID thing, he may have had something going to the can now in 2020, right? Bill Duke says he remembered the times when it would be raining, and him and his family's walking on the sidewalk, they would have to get off the curb and walk in the mud. Let me say it again. In Bill Duke's lifetime, he had to get off the curb and walk in the mud because black people couldn't be on the same curb as white people. You couldn't look a white man in the eye. See, these are the things that you must be aware of. So when you start talking about, oh, that was a long time ago, how does this hurt me, blah, 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 I'm doing pretty good. When you're living in the country in which it's okay to dismiss you and treat you as if your life isn't valuable 100 years ago, and it was state, basically, people don't understand that the United States federal government helped fund the Ku Klux Klan. The Ku Klux Klan and those Knight Riders